Hello, my foodies. I hope you all are doing well. Before we discuss food fortification in detail, let us try and understand what this fortification actually means. In simple terms, when we intentionally increase the essential micronutrient content, that is key vitamins and minerals such as iron, iodine, zinc, vitamins A and D of any food commodity for improving two things, that is number one, its nutritional quality, and number two, consumer health. Then in that case, it is termed as fortification. And the food that has undergone this process is called fortified food. But do you guys really know why food fortification is important? I know by now you must have understood what is the main aim behind this initiative. Yes, you guessed it right. Their main aim is to fight micronutrient deficiencies in India, because we all know that hidden hunger is a serious health risk. See, sometimes what happens, our diet is either unbalanced or sometimes we do not include variety of food in our diet. In all these cases, what happens, our body does not get adequate amount of essential micronutrients. Now, this deficiency can be bridged in a special way, and that is by fortifying our staple food. Now, since we all know about what is fortification and what is the main aim behind fortifying foods, it is also important to understand how food fortification has been going on since old times. To understand this, let's remember the day from 1953 when iodine fortified salt and vitamin A fortified hydrogenated oil were mandated. Let us understand this concept better with the help of some facts and figures. According to the National Family Health Survey, that is NFHS, 58.4% of children in the age group 6 to 59 months are anemic. 53.1% women in the reproductive age group are anemic. 35.7% of children under 5 are underweight. I hope now you all must be clear that why fortification is much needed in India. With this, now let's discuss what are the benefits of fortification. India is an agricultural-based country. Mostly people here depend on staple food crops for their day-to-day survival, and for this reason, in case of fortification, nutrients are added to the staple crops so that larger population can be covered all at once. Secondly, it is completely safe method. It doesn't have any health risk associated with it. The quantity of micronutrients are added as per recommended daily allowances, that is RDA, and these are well regulated as per prescribed standards for safe consumption. Also, this method is very cost effective, and it does not alter the taste, aroma, or texture of food which is being fortified. Coming on to the major fortified staples, it includes wheat flour, rice, salt, edible oil, and milk. Among these, wheat flour and rice is fortified with iron, folic acid, and vitamin B12. Whereas salt is fortified with iron and iodine, that is why it is called double fortified salt. And edible oil and milk is fortified with vitamin A and D. So foodies, what are you waiting for? If next time your mother gives you the responsibility of rationing the house, then you must keep these brands in mind, because these are all fortified food brands. And yes, do not forget to check the plus F symbol mentioned on the food packets before purchasing them. If you're going to buy wheat flour, then you should take all these brands. If you are going to buy rice, then you should go for these brands. While purchasing salt, go for these brands. Well, that's it for today. Stay tuned for this kind of short and crisp information related to food industry. See you next time. Till then, goodbye. Take care.